What's up, everybody? It's Smogwai over here, and today I'm going to be reviewing a Dragon Ball Xenoverse 2 for the Nintendo Switch. So, let's talk about this. Let me get this out of the way. Online mode. You know, playing online mode, it is really fun. Don't get me wrong. Playing online mode, you know, you with other people, you get to fight each other and all that shit. I enjoy doing that, but the only bad thing is it has one really bad thing about online mode that I think everyone should know. There's not a lot of players, dude. Like, number one, yes, I played like a few games, right? Like, maybe four games out of the whole week I had this game. And I'm like, what the fuck? You know what I mean? It's like, yo, it's a really, really fun game to play online mode, in my opinion. But the only issue is, like, where is everyone? You know what I mean? It struggles on the, you know, player base. You know, like, how many players does this game have? It doesn't even show, like, you know how in the old Call of Duty, it's like 3,000 people, whatever the fuck. This game does not show how many players it has. And if it did, it will show the truth and will make Bankai and Nintendo Switch look really, really bad. Because that's how bad it is. So, it sucks that it doesn't have online mode, because I really did enjoy the games I did play online mode. You know, you get to fly around, you get to fight people and all that. I enjoyed it. Now, they do have this other mode where, you know, you pick your team, you pick your enemy's team, and then you get to fight like that, you know what I mean? And that is really enjoyable. That's one of the best modes in this game, you know? Story mode-wise, kinda, it's okay, nice. I will say it's acceptable. It's not like, oh shit, it's garbage and all that. It's acceptable, you know. It does have, you know, like, the graphics wise, oh, that's next, you know. But, you know, story mode is okay. It's really not my thing, you know. I didn't really, really get into it, but I try to a lot. And, you know, it has that feeling of, you know, okay, imagine like this. It's like an online shooter, you know, or online game, you know, like, say, survival mode or Street Fighter 5 or Call of Duty Domination, you know, like, you're like, okay, I lost this game, but I'm gonna try it again, you know. I'll just try it a few more times, because it's fun, you know. It's fun, challenging in a good way, but it could get a little bit annoying, you know what I mean? It's one of those. But that doesn't mean it's like an awful game because of that. Because it still is fun, but it does get annoyed once in a while. You know what I mean? But I think that's normal because, you know, who's going to be playing the same game the whole year round without getting bored? You know what I mean? So that's not as bad as, like, let's say, oh, it's glitchy, the game. Or it's kind of, you know, the frame rates drop and you can see a dramatic, you know, a huge difference between this game on Switch, and this one's just like, oh shit, man, this is a bad port. You know what I mean? Like, it's not like that, but it's acceptable, I would say. Do I think this is a game of the year? Oh man, it's a possibility. I could see in the future, if a lot of people buy this game, there will be a lot of people, you know, surround a huge fan base or a big enough fan base to be acceptable around, like, Mario Kart 8, you know, Deluxe, you know, has, like, a fan base and a lot of people's playing that. I could see it in the future, but in my opinion, I don't think a lot of people's, you know, they should do a little bit more advertising towards this game, because it is really a fun game online mode, but the only bad thing is it's not a lot of people to play, and that's the thing that was killing it for me, and I kind of was like, yo, Nintendo Bankai, at least do a little bit more fucking advertising. Stop with the Super Mario Odyssey. Like, everyone knows Mario, yo. Okay, like, we all know the new game dropped, okay? Like, I'm still seeing, yo, I barely watch TV. I'm mostly, like, on YouTube and other stuff. But I barely see trailers of this game, you know? And I'm like, you have. Everyone knows Mario already. Like, it's out, of course. Everyone knows these other games on Switch and all that. Yes, it's important to advertise those games too. But this game, how old is this game? Like a month old on Switch now? I don't know. So I didn't keep up with this one. I think it recently came out. I don't know. Tell me in the comments. But my opinion is, it really needs more players online. Because it really is a good, it's a great game. You know, it's online mode wise, you know. But story wise, I would say I was kind of confused. I was like, what the fuck do I do now? I beat this thing, you know. I was like, you know what I mean? So that's my review on that. In my opinion, is it a good game? I think it's a great game, you know. It's a game I would say is better than most of the games I have for the Nintendo Switch. Okay. Well, it's in the middle of my favorite games of the Nintendo Switch. Okay. So, with that being that, I hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to comment, subscribe, and stay tuned for the review of Need for Speed Payback, because that one is a review to listen to. So, until next time, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Tell me if you have this game, and until next time, bye.